Welcome in the video series of Mathematics Class 10th. Dear students, in the previous video, we learned how to solve the quadratic equations by factorization method. In this video, we are going to learn solution of quadratic equation by completing the square. So let's see how to solve the quadratic equation by completing the square method. Now dear students, here we have the equation x square plus 6x minus 2 is equal to 0. Let's solve this equation by the factorization method. So what we are doing in the factorization method? So let's take the product of first and the last term. That is negative 2x square. Okay? Now here we have to find out the factors of 2 such that their subtraction. Why subtraction? Because it is negative. Their subtraction should be middle term, that is 6. So here, is it possible to get the factors of 2 such that their subtraction is 6? So dear students, here definitely not. We are not easily able to find out the factors of 2 such that their subtraction is 6. It means that here the factorization method has certain limitation. Okay, so every time for all the quadratic equation, we cannot use the factorization method. So to overcome this problem, we have the second method, that is completing square method. Okay, so let's solve the same example by the completing square method. So let's see how to solve. Dear students, in the completing square method, what we do? We transfer this third term to the RHS. Okay, so let's write down x square plus 6x minus 2 is equal to 0. This is our equation. So x square plus 6x. So this negative 2 will be the positive 2. Okay. Now here, after transferring the third term, that is constant term, to the RHS, now we'll try to make this LHS as a perfect square. Okay. So here, x square plus 6x. So here we have to add the third term such that this LHS will become the perfect square expansion. Okay. So here, x square plus 6x plus 9. So here, if we will add the 9 to the LHS, so we'll get x square plus 6x plus 9. So dear students, you can see here, this is the expansion of x plus 3 bracket square. Okay, so that is a plus b bracket square. What is the expansion? A square plus 2ab plus b square. So here 3 square, that is 9, 2ab, that is 3 into 2 into x, that is 6s. Okay, so here as we added the 9 to the LHS, same way we have to add to the RHS also. Okay, so 2 plus 9. So here we get RHS as a 2 plus 9, that is 11. Okay, now here LHS is the perfect square. Okay, and RHS is 11. So what we do now here, we'll take out the square root from both sides. So let's take out. What are the roots? That is negative 3 plus 11, root 11 and negative 3 minus root 11. Okay, so in this way you can solve this quadratic equation by the completing square method. Now here the problem is that here easily we add the 9, here we added the 9. But how do we control that this number only we have to add? So dear students, here let's learn how to add the third term. Okay, so let's here we have a formula to find out the third term which we have to add to the LHS. So the formula is third term is equal to 1 upon 2 into coefficient of x. Coefficient of x. Bracket square. Okay? So now let's put the value 1 upon 2 into coefficient of x. What is the coefficient of x? That is 6. And bracket square. So here 2 ones are 2, 2 threes are 6. So here we got 3 ones are 3, 3 square, that is 9. Okay? So in this way, by using this formula, we can find out the third term. And whatever will be the third term we will get, that we have to add to the both sides. So that our LHS will become the expansion of perfect bracket square. Okay? So let's see some examples that we can solve by this completing square method. Dear students, here we have another quadratic equation. Let's solve it by the completing square method. Okay? So the equation is x square plus 2x minus 5 is equal to 0. Okay? We have to solve it by completing square method. So our equation is x square plus 2x minus 5 is equal to 0. So here whenever we apply the completing square method, first step is that we have to transfer the constant term to the RHS. Okay? So here constant term is negative 5. So it will become positive 5. Okay? So let's give it as the equation number 1. Now here as we learn that we have to make here LHS as the perfect square number, expansion of perfect square bracket. Okay? So for that here we have to add the third term. So let's first find out the third term. So we have the formula for the third term, that is third term is equal to 1 upon 2 into coefficient of x bracket square. Okay? So here 1 upon 2 into, what is the coefficient of x? That is 2. Okay, so multiplied by 2 and bracket square. So here this 2 2 will get cancelled. What will get in a bracket? 1 square. So 1 square is 1 only. Okay, so this third term will add on both the side of this equation first. Okay, so here x square plus 2x plus 1 is equal to 5 plus 1. Okay, now dear students, here we have to identify that this is the expansion of which bracket. So it's very simple. For that, what we do? Here x square is here, so that term is square, that is x. Okay? Give the sign of middle term. The sign of middle term is positive, that's why plus. Okay? And write the square root of this third term. So 1 square root of 1 is 1. Okay? So in this way, this is the expansion of x plus 1 bracket square. Okay? And RHS 5 plus 1, that is 6. Okay. Now here let's take out the square root from both sides. Okay. So after taking out square root from both sides, we get x plus 1 is equal to. Now here 6 is a non-perfect square number. That's why its square will be root 6. Okay. Now dear students, whenever we find out the square root of this RHS, we have to use both the sides. That is positive, negative. Okay. Now we want to find out the value of x. So this 1 is plus. So let's transfer it to the RHS. It will become minus. So we will get here x is equal to minus 1 plus minus root 6. Okay. So let's separate these signs. So here what I will take, x is equal to negative 1 plus root 6, or x is equal to negative 1 minus root 6. Okay, so in this way we got the roots of this quadratic equation, that is negative 1 plus root 6 and negative 1 minus root 6. These are the roots of given quadratic equation. Okay, so I hope the solution is clear to you. Let's see another example. So dear students, here we have another equation, that is 2y square plus 9y plus 10 is equal to 0. Okay, so this is our equation. Now dear students, here what the previous equation we have solved, in that the coefficient of x square was 1. Now here in the given equation, the coefficient of y square is 2. Okay, so here whenever we apply the completing square method, so make it sure that the coefficient of x square or y square should be 1. Okay, now here 2 is there. So first of all, we have to cancel this 2. Okay, so for that here we do divide by 2 on both sides. Okay, so again dear students, here before going to find out the third term, make it sure that coefficient of x square or y square should be 1. If it is not 1, then in that case whatever is the coefficient, we have to cancel that by dividing the same number. Okay, so here divide by 2 on both sides. So as we divide it, so what we get? Y square plus 9 upon 2y plus 10 upon 2, that is 5, is equal to 0. Okay, so in this way we got this equation. Now here, in the previous example I said that here after getting the equation, transfer the constant term to the RHS. So here our constant term is 5. So let's transfer it to the RHS. As it is a plus 5, it will become minus 5. Okay, so this is our equation. Y square plus 9 upon 2 y is equal to negative 5. Let's give it as an equation first. Okay, so here after this what we did, we made the coefficient of y square as a 1 and we transfer the constant term to the RHS. Okay, now let's find out the third term. What is the formula to find out the third term? That is, third term is equal to 1 upon 2 into coefficient of y. Now here variable is y, that's why I wrote here 1 bracket square. Okay, now here 1 upon 2 into coefficient of y. What is the coefficient of y? That is 9 upon 2 bracket square. Okay, now let's solve this. So here 9 ones are 9, 2 twos are 4 bracket square. So let's write down the square. Square of 9 is 81, square of 4 is 62. So in this way we got the third term. After getting this third term, what we do? We'll add this third term, that is 81 upon 16, on both sides of equation first. Okay, so here y square plus 9 upon 2y plus 81 upon 16. Similarly, add to the RHS. Our RHS is negative 5 plus 81 upon 16. Okay, now let's solve this. So here in this way we got the LHS as the expansion of perfect bracket square. Now here we have to write this is the expansion of which bracket. So it's very simple. Write down the square root of this first term, that is y square is there, so its square root will be y. Give the sign of middle term, plus is there, that's why it will give you here plus. If minus will be there, that will give you minus. Okay, now here plus is there, that's why plus. And write the square root of this third term. Square root of 81, 9. Square root of 16, 4. Okay, it means that this LHS is the expansion of 1 plus 9 upon 4 brackets. Okay, now to this RHS. RHS, we have to add these both numbers, but here denominators are not same. So let's make it same. So 16 5s are 80. Negative 80 plus 81 upon 16. Okay, now here LHS will be as it is, y plus 9 upon 4 bracket square is equal to 80 is negative, 81 is positive. Different sign, subtraction. So 81 minus 80, that is 1 upon 16. Sign of bigger number, that is positive. So positive 1 upon 16. Okay, so in this way we got this. So now let's take out the square root from both the sides. Okay, now here as we take out the square root from this LHS, so what we get? Y plus 9 upon 4. The square will get cancelled. similarly to the RHS. Now here, in this example, RHS, that is more upon 16. 1 is a perfect square number and 16 is also a perfect square number. That's why easily we can write down their square. So 1 upon 16 is nothing but 1 upon 4. Square root of this 1 upon 16 is 1 upon 4. Again, don't forget to write the positive negative sign. We have to write both the signs. Okay? Now here we want to find out the value of y. So let's transfer this 9 upon 4 to the RHS. So as it is a plus, it will become minus. So we get y is equal to negative 9 upon 4 plus minus 1 upon 4. Okay? Now let's solve this. So one time we take it as a positive, one time as a negative. So here y is equal to negative 9 upon 4 plus 1 upon 4. Okay? So let's first solve this. So here already this denominators are same. So directly we can solve this. Negative 9 plus 1 upon 4. Okay? 9 is negative, 1 is positive. Different sign, subtraction. 9 minus 1, that is 8. And sign of bigger number, that's why negative 8 upon 4. Okay, so here we can reduce this. 4 1 is 4, 4 2 is 8. So we got the value of y as a negative 2. Okay, now this side. Now we take the this negative 1 upon 4. So y is equal to negative 9 upon 4 minus 1 upon 4. Okay, so denominators are same. So let's subtract this. So y is equal to negative 9 minus 1 upon 4. Now here 9 is negative, 1 is also negative. Same sign, addition. 9 plus 1, that is 10. Sign of bigger number, that is negative 10 upon 4. Okay, so let's reduce it. So 2 is the 2, 5. Okay, so after reducing this, we will get the y is equal to negative 5 upon 2. Okay, so in this way, you should actually got the roots of the given quadratic equation, that is negative 2 and negative 5 upon 2 are the roots of given quadratic equation. Okay, so dear students, in this way, we have solved the sum quadratic equations by the completing square method. So here, one thing we have to keep it in mind. Here, before going to find out the third term, make it sure that for the given equation, the coefficient of x square or y square, whatever is the variable, so square, so its coefficient should be 1. And after making it 1, we have to transfer the constant term to the RHS. Okay, then we will find out the third term by using this formula. Okay, so I hope it's clear to you how to solve the quadratic equations by the completing square method. Thank you.